What's going down, friends? I'm your host, Jared Bronstein, and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that looks to answer any and all questions you may have, regardless of how likely or outlandish they may be. Make sure you hit that subscribe button as well as that bell to make sure you never miss a video. Of course, as we always do here at LBQ, I'll wrap up the video by responding to some of your comments from a previous video, but before that, we need to talk about what would happen if two hurricanes fused with each other. Well, this isn't so much a hypothetical question like a lot of the questions on here, but actually a very valid question that has happened in the past and will most likely happen sometime again. It's not something that happens too often, and really, depending on the size of the two storms, can completely change the storm's route or do nothing at all. We're going to explain everything that could happen if two hurricanes collided, something called the Fujiwhara effect. That's right. There's actually a name for this phenomena, if you'd call it that, and it's the Fujiwhara effect. Named after Sakuhi Fujiwara, the Japanese meteorologist who was the first to describe the effects of two storms colliding. Now, the Fujiwhara effect covers all storms colliding, not just hurricanes. We're talking hurricanes, cyclones, typhoons, tropical depressions, and so on. But for this video specifically, we're going to be covering what would happen if two hurricanes fused. Although the effects would most likely be the same across the board, let us know if you'd want to know what would happen if two cyclones collided in the comments down below. Now, I'm sure you guys want me to say if two hurricanes collided, you would get a massive destructive hurricane that's going to absolutely destroy the world. I mean, it's possible, but the odds are that of slim to none. I'd buy a lottery ticket first. But the idea of two hurricanes merging into one massive storm is definitely a possibility and has happened, most recently in 2005 when Hurricane Wilma absorbed Tropical Storm Alpha. It also happened in 1995 when Hurricane Iris interacted with Hurricane Humberto and then absorbed Tropical Storm Karen. Oh, Karen. But notice how Iris and Humberto interacted with each other, but one didn't absorb the other? That's because when two hurricanes collide, they don't necessarily always absorb one another. But let's get back to basics. For two hurricanes to collide with each other, there needs to be no more than a 900-foot distance from one to the other. Meaning, if two hurricanes are 1,000 feet apart from each other, they'll have absolutely no effect on each other. Or so we think. I'm sure it could affect the storm, but for anything to really go down, they need to be within 900 feet of each other, and that's the maximum. So when the two storms collide, what actually happens? Well, as previously mentioned, it really depends on the storm's size and power. If you have two equally strong hurricanes, they dance, as people call it, around the common midpoint between the two, meaning they never go directly into one another, they just move in ways that people call dancing around the most center point between the two storms. Eventually, they get tired of dancing and go their own ways. This can cause a storm to change its original trajectory, which is what happened in 2018 when Hurricane Helene changed the direction of Tropical Storm Joyce. Although Helene was much stronger than the tropical storm, it didn't absorb Joyce, just redirected it to the east. However, if a less powerful hurricane gets close enough to a larger, more powerful storm, the smaller one can definitely get engulfed by the large storm. Of course, this makes the stronger hurricane even more powerful. It doesn't necessarily make it wider, but it can help strengthen a hurricane which is losing its power. Or it can literally just get absorbed and not make it more powerful at all. It doesn't work as I'm sure most of you think it does. For example, if a hurricane with maximum winds of 115 miles per hour collided with another hurricane with max winds of 130 miles per hour, it wouldn't form a storm with max winds of 245 miles per hour, it would literally just add more fuel to the fire that is the 130 mile per hour storm. So what does this mean? Well, although hurricanes fusing doesn't happen all that often, when it does, it can help prolong the life of a hurricane. This, of course, could be problematic because we know the type of damage hurricanes are capable of doing. And with the rate at which hurricanes seem to be steadily increasing due to climate change, we may be in store for this occurrence to happen more often, something that wouldn't be beneficial to us in any way. Even if two hurricanes don't necessarily fuse, the idea of them changing their direction is quite terrifying if you ask me. Now, as always, I love hearing from you guys, so please drop some comments down below with your thoughts on the Fujiwhara effect. I personally find it incredibly interesting, but also kind of scary. Although it's good to know that we're not going to have a massive megastorm that takes over the entire planet, the fact that hurricanes can redirect each other if they come close enough because they dance around the most central point is definitely concerning, to say the least. I mean, we don't get hurricanes here in Toronto, but I don't know what would happen if we did. Maybe that can be our next LBQ. Let us know in the comments down below if you'd be interested in seeing that. For now, let's reply to some comments from the video. What if the Deinosuchus didn't go extinct? Master Chief said, what if you stop making us die? I'll be honest, Master Chief, a lot of the videos I've done lately, it doesn't affect the human race. Like great white sharks doubling in size, this video, the Deinosuchus coming back to life, it doesn't, you know, kill everybody, so a handful of people might be affected because, you know, they're in the water surfing or something like that, but for everyday people that live on land like us, we don't die, we're all good. Smithboy1010 said, I thought they misspelt dinosaurs really bad. No, we spelt it right. It was Dinosuchus. It was a type of dinosaur that obviously went extinct, or I guess crocodile. We got a whole team here that checks over everything, and of course, we are humans, we make mistakes. I'll be honest, I stumbled like 4 or 5 times while recording this video, but the editors make me look good because they cut it together, and there's people on the back end that do the titles and the thumbnails. We got a great production team here that makes sure everything is done perfectly, and every now and then, yeah, we make mistakes, but I mean, we're humans. It happens. But in this case, no mistake was made. The Dinosuchus is an animal that went extinct, and that was the name of it, so they titled it properly. And that's gonna do it for this one, guys. I've been your host, Jared Bronstein. Make sure you guys give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Make sure you are subscribed and ring that bell notification so you guys never miss a video, and we'll see you in the next one.